Hi, I'm Colin Nicholson, head PGA golf professional at Wycliffe Golf and Country Club. Here today to help you with some tips from home. One of the common errors that we see in a golfer's swing is poor posture, and that's pre-swing and in-swing. So one of the tips to help you from home, something you can practice and work on, is just getting into a good posture and what it feels like. One of the common errors that I see in posture and setup is a real rounded shoulder look, which is rounded back, rounded shoulders. What happens when your shoulders are rounded in your setup is it limits the amount of rotation that you're able to have with your shoulder turn and your back. To increase the shoulder turn, we want to feel like we have our shoulders back as we're standing tall. And to get into a good posture, you can do this drill. Just have a slight knee bend as we stand tall, straight up, shoulders back. We're gonna put our hands on our thighs. And from there, we're just gonna bend down. Our rear is moving this way, upper body moving out over what would be the ball. And we're just gonna feel our fingertips come to the top of our kneecaps or just about an inch above your kneecaps, whatever feels comfortable for you. But as you can see, I don't have rounded back, rounded shoulders. I'm in good posture, giving myself space to make that good shoulder turn in the backswing. Okay, that's one tip to help. Let me recap that. We're going to stand tall, slight knee flex, shoulders back, hands on our thighs. Now we're going to bend down, rear is going out over the heels. Gonna feel our fingertips work their way down to about an inch above your kneecaps or even down to your kneecaps, whichever feels best for you. And there you're in a good posture and able to make a good shoulder turn in the backswing. Okay, create some space. Now in swing, one of the common errors is we see golfers losing their posture in the swing. And one is in the backswing. Common error you see is someone who's trying to gain more distance, making a larger turn, and what's considered a false turn by taking the club back and having a lot of lift. So you start to see the upper body rise, the head goes about 6 inches above where it began. And then when you come back down, there's a lot of movement down towards the golf ball. That creates a lot of inconsistencies in the golf swing and very challenging to make consistent contact. So one of the things we need to focus on in that backswing is making sure our head stays still in our posture. And as soon as the shoulders stop rotating, that's where you've completed your backswing. You don't need any extra where we're trying to lift up towards the sky. So one of the drills you can use to help you stay in posture and limit head movement up and down in the backswing and also in the follow through is actually finding a wall. Get into a good posture where what we just spoke about, having shoulders back, down to top of the knees, feeling like your head just barely touches that wall. Now, once you're in posture, you're gonna cross your arms on each shoulder and we're gonna feel rotation in the backswing. And you want that head to stay right on the wall. We don't wanna see any lifting off. Once again, we're gonna feel our head slightly touching the wall in the backswing. We're gonna feel our shoulders rotate as our weight shifts into that back leg. And now we're actually gonna make a downturn, downswing as we shift our weight into the left leg and rotate through. Now past the golf ball, the head will obviously lift as everything turns towards the target. These are a couple of tips you can use from home to help you get into posture and stay in correct posture during the swing. We hope you find these tips useful and everyone is staying safe at home during this time. Thank you. Hope you have a great day.